There is prolonged absorption, there's delayed toxicity. It takes about 30 minutes to take effect. You've got a 3 to 6 hour peak, and then it can be in your system for a duration of sort of like 12 hours. People think that, you know, who buys a brownie and takes one bite and then puts it away, wraps it back up in a package? You don't do that. People are making this mistake all across Colorado where they are taking a bite, they don't get anything because they're expecting to get this high. Well, what do they do? Well, a little bit more. It's like you open up a package of Doritos. No one can eat just one, right? So toxic congestions have gone way up. Not just for kids, because we talk about, you know, a lot of these are gummies or lollipops, things that are appealing to kids, but this is in adults as well. So youth access has gone up, youth usage has gone up, especially in those opt-in communities like Amy was talking about. The academic problems, we've seen evidence of those that are well documented. The lower graduation rates, the increased use of other drugs, the effect on the developing brain, especially up to age 21, the frontal lobe where you make your judgment and decision-making area for your brain, that's the area that's being affected. Impaired driving. So this is going to be a disaster in terms of how do you enforce this. How high is someone? Well, we know we can get an alcohol level, but THC levels don't correspond with your level of intoxication. So it's all going to be sort of a clinical decision. And people may say, well, marijuana is not as, you know, it's not as bad as someone who took a couple opiates or who had a couple of drinks of alcohol. Well, if it's my kid or if it's your family member that is involved in an accident caused by someone who is impaired based on whether they're taking an opiate, whether they took too much alcohol, or whether they had too much THC, does it matter to you how impaired, what they're impaired from? The same thing, we're going to see it either way. They're going to come to the emergency department. And I do not want, it's going to happen anyway because there's some legalization is going to increase access. But the last thing we need to do is have it prevalent in our community where we have retail shops with easy accessibility.